Uniqueness of this day. We've done other dedications of benches. When we did the memorial to the Vietnam veterans on the other side, that had a specific character to it. But today's dedication and memorial has a character all of its own. And so I hope that you all have the opportunity to appreciate the sensitivity and the connectedness that we all have together to the people who are here in remembering those who have gone. Let's bow our heads in prayer, please. Majestic God of all creation, we pray today for our country and all who serve and all who have served. Lord God, we pray for the families who also serve by losing precious days and weeks and months spent with their loved ones who are off serving, preserving peace and the freedom we have in this country. We come to you in prayer for the families who paid the ultimate price, whose loved one died or was taken captive and never returned. Today, oh God, we pray for those who have died in freedom struggle in Afghanistan and Iraq, and we remember those who have died not in battle but as bystanders. As we stand before this wall of names representing those in Ohio who have given the ultimate gift of their lives, we thank you, O God, for the peace that you impart to us. That your Son, Jesus Christ, though dying a death of pain, also brings a serenity and a wholeness to our suffering souls that guide us in our lives to deal with our losses, our discomforts, and our disappointments. We pray today for anyone who may be held in captivity and think perhaps that they are forgotten. We will not forget. I do not forget. God has not forgotten or forsaken us as we remain faithful in remembering. We pray today, O God, for your grace, for your care, and for your presence among us today as we remember. Amen.
Amen.
If you're ever able to go to Clinton, which is right off of Cleveland-Massillon Road, head south out of Clinton towards Canal Fulton, stop to see this wall. It's a wonderful tribute to our fallen young ladies and men that have given their lives for our freedom. World War I, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, and now Iraq and Afghanistan. That was the dedication last weekend, to dedicate the addition of the wall to the Iraqi and Afghanistan fallen heroes. Hopefully, God willing, there won't be any more additions to the wall. But this is some of what went on. We're going to hear Bob speak in a moment, but before we do that, let's take a look at some of the photographs that Nancy took, and we'll throw some appropriate music on top of it. We'll go to break and be back with more right after this. Watch.
Beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grace, for purple mountain majesties.
RacingCenterRacing.com. Find parts fast with customizable search options. Shop by keyword, brand name, make, model, and more. Plus, find great deals in the Saving Central section. Get parts quick and easy with online checkout and fast shipping. And get the job done right with helpful instruction sheets, part suggestions, and a huge tech archive. It's all at CenterRacing.com, your ultimate power tool.
Fix 2. Teen Kids Deli.
I'm Bob Schmidt, and the family and I have the Marathon Station at the corner of 2nd and Broad in Cauga Falls. Every Monday, you can save 10 cents off premium gas. Inside, we have 16 Kids Deli. We have a great box lunch for $4. It includes a 6-inch panini of your choice, bag of chips, and a 12-ounce can of any Coke product. Call your order in to 330-929-1616 and pick it up when you drive by.
16KidsDeli.com. 16 Kids Deli.
Did you know the biggest source of energy loss in your home isn't your windows?
It's your walls.
And USA Insulation will show you why. Our premium foam can save you up to 50% on your energy bill.
Other insulation can't compare. I have a higher R value, get into hard-to-reach places, and won't settle over time.
Insulate your home now, get up to $250 off, and be comfortable year-round. Visit USAinsulation.net.
USA Insulation.
Home, home.
Now only at Orlo Auto Parts. Pour 15 Rust Preventative Paint. Paints directly over rust. Dress up and clean up with the help of the know-how crew at Orlo Auto Parts. Anywhere rust occurs, just brush on Pour 15. That's Pour 15 at Orlo Auto Parts. Akron, Barberton, Doylestown, Rittman, Orville, Wooster, and Millersburg.
My son did the voiceover for that commercial. He left out Portage Lakes. Poor Portage Lakes. They're on the list, but we will chastise him properly when we talk to him soon. Poor 15 also at Portage Lakes, Orlo Auto Parts. We're about ready for Bob Early portion of this, but we opened with a very lovely young lady that did just a perfect rendition of the national anthem. Let's watch that. And then we'll see Early, Bob Early, our Bob Early, in action at the wall. Watch.
Who will be leading us in the national anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance.
Color Guard, preset, hook!
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets roared galore, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the
cool, the way the wind just started at the appropriate time to cause the flags to wave in the air. That very cool, huh? I gotta give credit to Nancy. She did a pretty good job. I don't know if I could have done any better myself. Well, maybe. Maybe. All right, and then we had some guest speakers, some folks from Columbus, and another person from our area. Let's watch Bob in action. Watch.
Thank you, Scott. Again, earlier, out of place, I might admit, I said the date August 4th, 2012. And the reason I say that, this is going to be a special day for all of us, that we're going to share something. It's going to be a day we don't forget. I think it's going to be a memory that all of us are going to hold dear. Today is a day we're here to celebrate those Ohio veterans who paid the ultimate sacrifice in the war against terrorism, from the Beirut bombing through enduring freedom in Iraq, and of course into Iraq and Afghanistan. This is also a day out of uniform. We remember our grandchildren, our sons, our daughters, our brothers and sisters, our spouses, and our friends. This, ladies and gentlemen, is hallowed ground. And today is a day where we will celebrate these heroes who didn't take any quarter. They didn't give any quarter. They enlisted so that we could be here today to celebrate what our heroes in the military have done forever in this great country. There's an old expression, you can take the soldier out of the service, but you can't take the service out of the soldier. And with this gathering today, I think we have proven that. And again, I am just honored and humbled and so blessed to be able to be here with you today to help celebrate this memory that we will share together. I'm going to start this off by bringing up one thing, and I don't even think they wanted me to do it, but I'm doing it anyway. The greatest thing about this park, many of you may not know this, is the OMVP is a 501c3 nonprofit. They take no money from politicians. They take no money from special interest groups or super PACs. They take no money from greedy corporations who want to litter up this hallowed ground with signage so that you will buy more of their widgets. This board, led by Ken and Ray, Veronica, and Steve Cripple, not only walk the walk, I should say not only talk the talk, they walk the walk. What began as a dream in 2009, and many would say a pipe dream, to build this magnificent place was undertaken by this private board based on private donations from folks like you and I. And I think that speaks the best of America. The best of America. So I would ask you to give a little of your heart on a donation today if you feel so inclined. Believe me, they did not want me to say that. But I think you can be proud when you see a board member today to know what they did for all of us. For this is the longest standing free granite wall in the United States, right here in beautiful Clinton, Ohio, Mayor. So I'm not going to keep you out in the sun. We have some important people that I'm going to introduce. And the first one I'm extremely proud to introduce, she was a Springfield Spartan. She was even a hot cheerleader in those days. She's hot now, what the hell, let's be honest about it. But she worked her way out of Springfield and worked her way through the University of Akron, keeping her roots right here among us. She got a job with one of the finest accounting firms in the United States and worked her way up the ladder very, very quickly. See, Mary, if I said it took a long time, they'd want to know how old you are, and I don't want to do that. So she actually worked herself up very quickly. She became the state auditor, and now I'm proud to say she is the 65th lieutenant governor and the hottest in the state of Ohio. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to introduce one fine person, and I mean that here, Miss Mary Taylor.
Okay, I am the hottest. I am dripping sweat. How about you? It's very warm. Well, thank you for inviting me to be with you. It's certainly an honor to be here to celebrate the sacrifices of those that have given or paid the ultimate price. Your family, your husband. I can't tell you what it means to me personally to know that these men and women are so willing to fight every day to protect our freedom and to protect the United States of America. A Gold Star father, he doesn't want recognition. He's like everybody here. You're not here because you want somebody to acknowledge greatness or sacrifice. You're here because you love our country. You're here because you love the service. And people like me are forever in debt to all of you who have served, who continue to serve, and of course, all of those who lost their lives serving our country. I was here for the original unveiling of the wall to Vietnam veterans. Over 3,000 Ohioans lost in Vietnam. And today we're going to unveil a wall that ultimately will include over 300 names of those lost in our most recent wars. I looked at this one bench and this gentleman was killed in service in 2011, but he was born in 1985. So now I'll tell you my age. I graduated in high school in 1984. I can't imagine the sacrifices that those people were making, have made throughout the history of this country. So it is an honor for me to be here. It is an honor for me to thank you. It's a privilege for us to thank you and to tell you that your state and your nation is forever in your debt for serving this country and for those that have made the ultimate sacrifice by giving up their loved ones so we could stand here today in a very hot, nice day in Ohio to recognize and remember those names and those individuals and what they represented when we unveil this wall. I do have a resolution from Governor Kasich and signed by me as well. I'm not going to read it because I think it's too important of a ceremony to read just words. But I will tell you, it says that we are forever in debt and grateful for the sacrifices you have all made. God bless all of you, and God bless the United States of America.
I think it's real important that you know that Mary and our next speaker weren't politicking to get here. They didn't. They both have extremely busy schedules. They truly wanted to be here. And I would tell you if it was any different, you know that. So without further ado, let me introduce you to our next speaker. He was born in Pennsylvania, so he was a Steeler fan. He probably doesn't want all of you to know that. But now I think he's changed.
Milich's Village Inn is located at 4444 South Cleveland Maslin Road in Norton. It's a family-run business. They've been around since 1955. The regulars like the friendly, family-like staff and the consistent quality of the menu items. They're serving up American and Serbian-American food in their casual atmosphere, and they're most known for their fried chicken. In addition to the chicken, they also serve shrimp, fish, ham, and steak dinners. So if you've not been out there before, get out to Milich's Village Inn, located in Norton.
For over 21 years, Portage Lakes Automotive and Tire Center has been the place for reliable and honest car care. Portage Lakes Automotive is a full-service automotive service center with an emphasis on value and service at affordable prices. We also offer all major brands of tires. We're proud to be family-owned and operated. Highly recommended by Handy Randy. Conveniently located at 3408 Manchester Road. Open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. Call 330-644-5724 or online at portagelakesauto.com. If you have any transmission problems or questions, make sure to call Millennium Transmission first. With 25 years experience and an ASE certified master technician on staff, Millennium Transmission will deliver quality transmission work that's guaranteed. Millennium Transmission offers free diagnostics and firm estimates before they dismantle your vehicle. Conveniently located on Waterloo Road just off Route 224. Call Millennium Transmission today at 330-773-1998 or on the web at millenniumtrans.biz. Mention Handy Randy and get a transmission scan and diagnosis free, a $65 value.
Now, exclusively at Orlo Auto Parts, Rain Eater Wiper Blades. Easy fit and made from superior natural rubber, Rain Eater Blades feature anti-clogging and aerodynamic wiper blades to fit your car or truck. Stop in today to see the know-how people at Orlo Auto Parts. Akron, Barberton, Doylestown, Portage Lakes, Rittman, Orville, Worcester, and Millersburg.
We're out of time. I was going to show you where Bob Early, Jim Renacci, is about to speak. And Jim was, it was his turn, and he started to get up, and Bob told him to sit down. I said, Bob, you don't tell a guy that maybe someday he's going to be the governor or the president to sit down. That can come back and haunt you someday or early. Just remember that. The guy might be king someday, for all you know. So let's go out with some more photographs of that wonderful memorial and car show and another appropriate song. We'll see you next week. We got lots of stuff that Nancy shot over the weekend. Rittman, Doylestown, some more Clinton next week. Thanks for watching. Bye.
For over 40 years, Akron Canton Waste Oil Company has been the place to collect and recycle used oil. Akron Canton Waste is the oldest locally owned and operated facility of its